sales. So we have written two sales and the date is 4th. Now coming to the next transaction, which is on 12th, goods returned by Sudha. Because it is a credit sale. So in a credit sale or a credit purchase, we discuss that goods can be returned. So as a result, you find Sudha returning goods to you to the extent of 4,000. So when Sudha returns the goods to you, you are getting back the goods, it becomes sales returns. So we will debit sales returns, and you know we have to credit Sudha's account because Sudha is the giver here. So based on this journal entry, we credit Sudha's account with 4,000 rupees. So we are writing 4,000 on the credit side. And buy is a constant, you know, and the reason is sales returns. So the date being 12th. So 12th February. Now, the next transaction is on 22nd. It says that, the next transaction is on 16th. It states that cash received from Sudha. If we journalize this transaction, cash being real account, we have to debit it. And Sudha being personal account, she is the giver, we have to credit her. So your journal entry would be cash account debit to Sudha's account. So in this journal entry, again we are crediting Sudha. As a result, what we need to do is again write the amount of cash what we got from Sudha on the credit side. So on credit side, we write 3,000. Now you know buy is a constant. Why are we crediting her account with 3,000? Because we got cash. That is the reason you are writing in the particulars. Now, the date is 16th. Now let us see the next transaction, which is on 22nd. It states that received check from Sudha. Received check from Sudha. So whenever we receive check, we know that a bank is involved. So bank is a personal account and also Sudha is a personal account. So what does this bank ultimately doing? It is collecting the money from Sudha and adding in our account, or what we say, it credits our account. So bank will be the receiver of the money from Sudha on our behalf. So we have the bank is the receiver, so personal account debit the receiver. So the entry becomes bank account debit to Sudha's account. Bank account debit to Sudha's account, because Sudha is the giver of the check. So credit the giver. So what we have to do now in the ledger of Sudha or account of Sudha, we have to put it on the credit side, the amount of 6,000 which we got from Sudha in the form of check. Now we are crediting Sudha's account with 6,000. As a result, we need to state the reason why. We got a check. Check means, you remember, we use the word bank. So by bank, the date is 22nd. Now let us see what is the next transaction. It states that Sudha account settled with 10% discount. Sudha settles the account with 10% discount, meaning if you see, there are some amounts on the debit side, some amounts are on the credit side. The debit side, the reasons being, you sold goods to Sudha on credit, therefore she has to give you money. Now ultimately she has given you some money, still there will be some balance when you see the balancing. So in this problem, it is stated that she is settling that balance, means the balance amount also she is giving, but she is settling with a discount. She is settling with a discount means she is asking you for some concession and you might have given that concession. So let us first check what is the amount which she has to settle. So the simple way would be total both the sides roughly and find out the difference. So if I total the debit side, it gives me a total of 19,000. So it's the debit. Now on the credit side, we have 13,000. So you can say totally she has purchased 19,000 worth from you and she has already returned or given to you 13,000 worth. Now how much she has to give as balance? 6,000 is the balance. So in the previous problem, this 6,000, this balance itself we have written as by balance carried down. But here you are not going to write because it is stated that she has settled the account with 10% account. Now let us see if 10%, 6,000 is the amount which she has to give to you. If you are giving 10% discount, means 10% of this 6,000 would come to rupees 600. That means she will not be paying you 600 as per the agreement with you. Now balance rupees 5,400 she will be giving you. So what you are getting from Sudha, you are getting 5,400. So first cash account debit to Sudha. This would be a journal entry for 5,400. As a result, you have to credit Sudha's account with 5,400. So what we do is we write this 5,400 on credit side. You know bias constant. Why we are writing 5,400? We are getting cash. So this is happening on the last day, this, or rather it is told on 28th. So we will take 28th. When date is not given, you can take the date as the last date of the month. Now, how about the 600? 600, it is you are giving a concession, means as though the person has given you money. But in reality, he didn't give money. So, but still we have to treat as all, as such he has given money and closed his account. So, 600, for 600 if you write the journal entry, it's a loss for you, which we call as discount allowed. So, we debit because it is a loss nominal account, and Sudha's account we have to credit because we have to close her account treating as if she has given you. So again we have to credit Sudha's account for the 600 what you are giving as a concession or discount allowed.